Hello, Andrew Wasson from CreativeGuitarStudio.com. Today I want to talk to you about problems with the playing and practicing of solos and in general creativity. But the crazy thing is that these are problems that you really shouldn't be having. Let's start with a quick look at the comment that I have for you from Noah in my video about the benefits of practicing early in the morning. And in particular, where Noah wrote, "My other best practice time is late, an hour or two before bedtime. Lots of creativity in those times." So if you do not do this, start doing it, because this is something to really pay attention to. And if you approach this the right way by going and having a lot of practice time later in the evening, you're going to see amazing benefits from late night practice time, especially when it comes to the boost that it seems to give in creativity. And we'll talk more about that later in the video. But first of all, let's just get started with the lesson here. Grab your guitar. I'm going to show you an easy but really great way to quickly get some creative practice time in late at night. Well, the first thing that I need to stress before you play and practice soloing is having a short time that you spend when you first sit down that's dedicated to composing chord progressions. And one of the easiest and best chord jams that you can focus on is the 1-4-5 progression. Let's try out a rare approach to the classic 1-4-5 that involves an idea called voice leading. The progression that you see on the screen right now below is in B major. And the harmony in the fourth measure is applying a unique descending bass line. So when you put the chords together, you get a really nice connection at the end of the progression there. So you got B major, F sharp, E, and then E D sharp, E C sharp, back to B. And you put it into a jam, you get something like this. And you can tell, I mean, it's just a 1-4-5. You know, the one chord is B, the five chord is F sharp, and the four chord is E. But I mean, you know, there's a different character to it now that you get this descending bass line. Sounds really interesting. It's like a melodic touch down in the lower region. And you can do this kind of work with pretty much any chord progression. You just have to kind of sit around with a little bit, think of the in terms of the scale tones, where things are at. And we're going to talk about those in a few minutes. But the idea, though, is, you know, get the chords down. We're in the key of B major. We have a B major bar chord in second position. From there, it goes to a second position five chord of F sharp major. It's a full bar chord. Then we have a rather unique E major chord. It's a fourth position E major with the small finger taking the low E tone there on the fifth string, seventh fret. Then we have our descending bass notes, D sharp and then C sharp, and then coming back around to the B chord again. So, you know, really work on these kinds of ideas where you create smooth connected bass lines, like the example that I've just done for you, because they can make a typical 1-4-5 progression sound completely different and really bring about a complete color change to the sound of the idea of the chords moving by. So coming up, I've got a great scale idea for you to learn and use with this chord progression. But first, I want to tell you about a special promotional offer that's related to my Handouts Collection ebook. I just want to take a moment to let you know about our Handout Collection ebook. I'd love for you to get a copy of this. There is a ton of great information in here. And if you already are one of the hundreds and hundreds of players who've received your copy, you already know how great this collection is. The ebook Handouts Collection is jam-packed full of different blank diagrams so you can notate anything you're working on scrap paper and start getting a better idea of how it operates. There's great scale exercises in here so you can understand the layouts of building melody a lot better, interesting stuff for diminished scale, ideas on modes. We have work on harmonized key centers, and there's ideas that go through the different kinds of diatonic chords that we have in keys. Plus, there's a fantastic arpeggio exercise in here. Plus, on top of that, we've got key signature theory and ideas for bar chords in here. There's just unbelievable amount of information in this thing. The Handout Collection ebook is available with any donation over $5 or if you make a purchase from my Creative Guitar Studio Teespring store. Visit creativeguitarstudio.com/donations to help support the guitar project, or you could check out all of our Teespring products in the console underneath this video. Once you have an interesting group of chord changes organized and you're ready for some creative work, the next step is to move into a small section of the associated scale. And this would best be a scale that's built within the same key signature. Now, this is important so that you can very quickly start getting right into some creative soloing work as quickly as possible. So here's an example of how you can approach your scale ideas on your fingerboard so that you can play some solos and take advantage of the neck very quickly and easily. When it comes to scale layouts for doing your soloing work and all your creativity work with creating melody, I like organizing the scales that I'm using for soloing in two regions of the fingerboard. We're going to first start with a lower string approach, and we're going to be using notes of the pentatonic, starting here off of the B at the fifth string, second fret. So this layout that I have starts on second fret, moves up through fourth and sixth. And then we have the fourth string on the fourth and sixth frets as well. And then we come around back through it again. So that's a very short and simple pattern, very easy to use for soloing. Right? And then we can extend that too into an upper group of notes, which gives us more range and expands our neck layout a little bit more. So in this case, what we're going to do is, remember, we're in the key of B. So we're going to take another B here on the third string, fourth fret. And what we're going to do is experiment with also including extra scale tones. I like doing that because the pentatonic sometimes gives you just enough notes to sound pretty decent, but it's always lacking one or two possibilities. So what we're going to do is use some pentatonic tones here, going from this B upwards in whole steps. This note here, by the way, on the eighth fret of third string, it's a duplicate of the second string fourth fret. So we have two of the same note in there. We're also going to add this note in, though. It's a fourth. It's an E. Tell, it gives you a really nice touch to add that fourth tone in. You can add other ones in, but I'm just going to go with that single note outside of the pentatonic there. So now we have quite a nice group of notes to work with to create some melody. So what I'm going to do next is hit the looper pedal. I'll record our progression that we had from before. And I'll use this scale pattern to just have some fun with. That if you try spending some serious time on soloing along with writing chord progressions, even recording or songwriting later in the evening, you are going to find that the late evening is one of the best times for creative work. You'll probably discover that you'll get really cool ideas and unique sounding phrases in the later hours of the night. I'm not sure why this is exactly. There have been some studies that say the human body is more alert to sounds and smells and sensations during the darker hours of the night, and there has been some research saying that creativity hits a high plateau at night because of the, you know, darkness and nighttime and its association with the unknown, which can cause our imagination to run wild. But whatever it is, if you haven't tried it yet, then be sure to apply the chord progression and scale concept I talked about in this lesson. Give it a go. Try to make some solos up and do some jamming with that stuff. 90% of songwriters and musicians swear by the later evening hours for peak creativity. And I know it definitely works for me as well. If you want to get a more detailed breakdown of all this information, including all the diagrams for each idea that I went over, then head down to my Blogger page. It's free at creativeguitarstudio.blogspot.com. And if you found this video helpful, make sure you leave your comments and thumbs up below. Also remember, if you're looking for a step-by-step guitar program that puts real tested methods into a proven guitar course, not just random YouTube videos, it's all available over at creativeguitarstudio.com. Plus, you'll want to make sure you're seeing all my lessons here on YouTube, so go and turn on those notifications and subscribe to the channel. All right, guys, I'll be back here again real soon with another video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you again next time. Bye for now. When it comes to online guitar lessons, there's no place better than creativeguitarstudio.com. General membership to the site is always free, and paid memberships to access our step-by-step beginner, intermediate, and advanced guitar programs are offered in reasonable monthly and annual packages. Skype lessons are also available if you need more specific instruction one-on-one to discuss the finer details of your guitar playing. Sign up today at creativeguitarstudio.com. I've got 25 years experience teaching guitar and have written a well-organized step-by-step guitar course. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for a free membership today. Join the thousands of members worldwide who have already enrolled. There's no need to try learning the guitar on your own. Let me help you become the best guitar player that you can be.